tomorrow morning class will be there, 7 to 8:30. Errors and approximation, small chapter is there. That way you may have already learned in physics. A very small chapter is there. Look at. Suppose Y is a function of t. Y is a function of time. Function of time. Look at this. Function of time. Now we have already discussed. Look at delta y divided by delta t. Delta y divided by delta t. So this is what I told. Change in y divided by change in time. Finite change. That means suppose y, let us say displacement. Y is displacement as a function of time. Displacement as a function of time. That means this will become delta s divided by delta t. So that means suppose a motion, a curve is there, right? So then a particle is at a and at t1, at t2. This, that means finite change in time is there. Finite change in time is there. Right? Finite change in time is there. At this displacement is what? At this displacement is what? F of t1. At this displacement is what? F of t2. That means this is nothing but change, final displacement minus initial displacement divided by change in time. Change in time. This is called this is called average. Average rate of change of y with respect to t. Average rate of change. This ratio is rate of change. And this delta y by delta t, that means if the time interval is finite, then that is called average rate of change of y with respect to t. Or otherwise, if it is displacement, it is called average velocity in the interval t1, t2. Average velocity will always be there in an interval. In an interval, that means final displacement minus initial displacement divided by final time minus initial time. Let us say dy by dt. This also we have discussed. dy by dt means, look at here. Suppose at any instant, let us say t1. At any instant t1, at t1 only, what is the velocity, he asks. That means when it is about to move from this point, let us say this is P, at this is f of t1. When it is about to move, that means immediately after t, there won't be any finite change. When it is about to move at that place, that is called instantaneous. Instantaneous rate of change of y with respect to t. If this is displacement, it is ds by dt. This is also called, in terms of displacement, instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity at time t1. At time t generally. That means when it is about to move from t, at that point t, whatever the velocity is called instantaneous velocity. This velocity is over an interval. This velocity is immediately at that point, right? So that means, look it. Whenever it is given, y as a function of time, if you want rate of change of y with respect to t, is nothing but d by dt of both sides, d by dt. That means f dash t. dy by dt is nothing but f dash t. Suppose s equals, suppose it is given like this, displacement. So instantaneous velocity v at t equal to 1. Instantaneous velocity at t equal to 1. V is nothing but ds by dt. Ds by dt means d by dt of this derivative. 3t squared is 6t plus 2. That means you will get at t equal to 1. That means 3 plus 6 plus 2, 11 units per second. 11 units per second. This is called instantaneous velocity. Suppose you have to calculate acceleration at t equal to 1. Acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity, instantaneous acceleration. That means derivative of this, that means 6t plus 6. At t equal to 1 means 6 plus 6, that means 12 units per second square. So this is called instantaneous velocity, or otherwise acceleration is also second derivative of displacement with respect to time. First derivative of velocity and second derivative of displacement. Now in this chapter we are going to discuss instantaneous changes of y or instantaneous changes of x with respect to t. Now look at, if y increases, then dy by dt greater than 0. If y is increasing, then dy by dt will be positive, because this is change divided by change. So y increases means final minus initial is what? It will be positive, right? If y increases, then we will take dy by dt positive. If y decreases, then dy by dt, rate of change of y with respect to time, is negative. If y decreases means final minus initial, dy is what? It will be negative, right? Now look at some problems. Look at the material. All of you, look at the material I have sent. First question. You write a question number one gap. After that, you write. For the curve, one curve is given. Y equal to 5x minus 2x cube. Y is a function of x. X increases at the rate of 2 units per second. This x increases. Dx by dt, rate of change of x with respect to t given. That means it is given 2 units per second. Right? X increases means dx by dt is 2 plus 2. So now what he is asking is, how fast is the slope of curve? changing. Okay. Slope of curve. Let us say m. Let us say m. He is asking how fast is the slope changing. That means he is asking dm by dt equal to dash. At what instant? At x equal to 3. At the instant when x equal to 3, how the slope of the curve is changing. Slope of the curve is nothing but, you know, slope of the curve is nothing but dy by dx. Slope of the tangent is nothing but slope of the curve. Dy by dx is nothing but what? 5 minus 6x square. 5 minus 6x square. Now this is slope. How slope is changing means you have to calculate dm by dt. With respect to t, you differentiate on both sides. This is 0 minus 6 into d by dt of x square. That means this is minus 6 into 2x, 12x into, you must write definitely dx by dt. D by dt of x is nothing but dx by dt. Now look at dm by dt. How m is changing with respect to time when x equal to 3? At what instant when x equal to 3? That means, so dm by dt at the instant x equal to 3 is nothing but minus 12 into 3 into dx by dt. Dx by dt means what? Dx by dt, it is always constant. That means minus 72. Minus 72. That means m decreases. Dm by dt is negative means what? M decreases. So that means the rate of change of m with respect to t is minus 72. Look at next problem. Second one. Look at the problem. A stone is dropped into a quiet lake and waves move in circles at the speed of 4 centimeters per second. At the instant when the radius of circular wave is 10 centimeters, how fast is the enclosed area increasing? Now there is a plain pond. Right, there is no disturbance in the water. A stone is dropped. That means it will form like this circles. Circular waves will be generated like this. Like this it will extend. It will extend. It will extend. Right? It will extend like that. He is telling, and waves move in circles at a speed of 4 centimeter per second. Let us say at any instant time, radius is r. How fast it is moving means dr by dt. If this radius increases, that much fast it will be moving. That means given that 4 centimeter per second. Let us say radius at any instant, radius if it is r, dr by dt is what? 4 centimeter per second. So he is asking how fast is the enclosed area. Look at this is the area. Now this is the area. This is the area. Area is changing. He is asking dA by dt equal to how much? At what instant? When the radius is 10 centimeter. That means when the radius become, let us say for this circle, 10 centimeter. How area is changing? That means A is what formula? Pi r square. Simple. dA by dt is nothing but pi into d by dt of r square. That means 2 pi r into dr by dt. At any instant time, dA by dt will be like this. Now what he is asking, when radius at the instant, when r is 10, this will become 2 pi into 10 into, this is 4. This is 4. So that means 80 pi. 80 pi area means centimeter square per second. Units it will be what? Da by dt, area means centimeter square divided by second. That means this area will increase at the rate of 80 pi centimeters per second. That means for each second, area will increase by 80 pi. Positive means what? Area will increase. Obviously, when the radius increases, area will also increase. That's why positive you got. Next, look at third one. Look at this cone type of models is very important. Look at. Water is dipping out at a steady rate of 1 cubic centimeter per second through a tiny hole at the vertex of a conical vessel whose axis is vertical. Right, when the slant height of water in the vessel is 4 centimeter, find the rate of decrease of slant height where the vertical angle of the conical vessel is pi by 6. There remove pi by 6 and write pi by 3. Remove pi by 6 and write pi by 3. Look, there is a conical vessel. There is a conical vessel which is with water. Water filled vessel this is. Conical vessel means always dimensions are, this is R, this is H height, this is R, this is base circle, right? So this is slant height. This is 90 degree, right? So vertical angle is given pi by 3. Semi-vertical angle. This and this will be equal. That is pi by 6. These both angles will be equal. Pi by 6. Now what he is asking? There is water in the vessel. There is a tiny hole in the bottom. Let us say there is a tiny hole. So water is dipping out. Water is going outside. How? That means volume is changing. dv by dt. Water is dipping out at a steady rate of, means water rate of change of volume is nothing but you have to write minus 1 centimeter cube per second. Decreasing means you take minus. This, what he is asking, now look at. Suppose it is full of water. Water is dipping out. At some instant, let us say like this, at any instant it will be like this. After some time, it will be like this. That means these dimensions will keep on changing. Now for this, if water level is still here, this is dimension of L, this is dimension of R, this is dimension of H. Each dimensions will change. What he is asking is, so definitely L will also change. dl by dt equal to how much when the slant height is 4 centimeter. That means when the slant height is 4 centimeter, how slant height is changing. Look at this. Now we have the volume formula. 1 by pi r square h. dv by dt is given. You have to calculate dl by dt. That means this completely you convert into L by using this triangle. Look at, by using triangle ABC, right angle triangle. So now I want to write R in terms of L. That means sine pi by 6 equal to R divided by L. That means R is nothing but L by 2. R is nothing but L by 2. So similarly, cos pi by 6 is nothing but cos pi by 6 is nothing but h divided by L. That means h is nothing but L root 3 by 2. H is nothing but L root 3 by 2. That means V equal to 1/3 pi into r square, that means l square by 4 into l root 3 by 2. H is nothing but l root 3 by 2. That means what you will get? Root 3 pi by 8 root 3 into l cube. This is volume in terms of slant head, because semi vertical angle you know. So that means now dv by dt you calculate. dv by dt is nothing but pi by 8 root 3 constant. For this it is 3l square into dl by dt. Into dl by dt. Now what he told? At l equal to 4 centi, at this instant, what is dl by dt? What is dl by dt? This is given minus 1 equal to pi by 8 root 3 into 3 into 16. Eight ones, eight twos, root three. dl by dt equals to minus 1 by 2 pi root 3. dl by dt means what? Unit centimeter per second. That means slant height decreases. Obviously, slant height decreases. That's why you got negative. So, in answer, he can give minus 1 by 2 pi root 3 or 1 by 2 pi root 3. Right? So, rate of change of slant head with respect to time is what? 1 by 2 pi root 3. Negative sign indicates that it will decrease. If minus is not given, if this is given also, then that is also correct. Like that, whatever the required in that function, you have to form volume. Next, look at fourth question. A water tank is in the shape of inverted cone. Same model. Look at. Is in the shape of inverted cone. Is in the shape of inverted cone like this, whose semi-vertical angle means this. So theta is nothing but tan inverse 0.5. So tan theta is nothing but 0.5. Water is poured at a constant rate of 5 cubic meter per hour. Now water is poured inside. Previously water is leaking out. So that means water is poured means dv by dt. Volume changes with respect to time. 5 cubic meter per hour. 5 cubic meter. Meter cube per hour. This. Now what he is asking? Find the rate at which water level is rising. That means this water keep on increasing. That means like this, keep on increasing like this. Increases like this. That means its depth will also increase. What he is asking is, water is rising at the instant. That means dh by dt equal to dash. When the depth of the water at the instant, when the depth of the tank is 4 liter. He wants dh by dt at the instant h equal to 4. That means what? Formula is 1 by 3 pi r square h. 1 by 3 pi r square h. Now in terms of h you have to convert. So now look at tan theta is nothing but r divided by h. So r is nothing but bring this side, h divided by h tan theta. H divided by 2. That means if you substitute here, At any instant, R will be H by 2. That means so this derivative done, dv by dt is 5 equals to 3 1s 3 4s 5 by 4 into at the instant h equal to 4, that means 16, this is so 16 dh by dt, 4 1s 4 4s, that means dh by dt is nothing but 5 divided by 4 pi centimeter per second. That means height increases at the rate of 5 by 4 pi centimeter per second. Like that, depending on the information given. Next, look at that. Next problem, 5. Look at here. Look at this problem. A conical vessel is there. He will give initial dimensions. These are initial dimensions given. That means initial dimensions. These are called whatever he has given. Initial step, initial dimensions. That means height 10, radius 5. These are Vessel dimensions. Vessel dimensions. It is being filled with water at the uniform rate of. It is being filled with water. That means 3 by 2 meter cube per minute. Meter cube per minute. The rate at which level of the water rises. dH by dt equal to how much? At the instant, h equal to 4. Now look at, when water is poured, its water level rises. You take at any instant of time, its position is like this. Its position is like this. At any instant, at time t, at any time, let the dimensions be, these are initial dimensions. At any time t, let the dimension be r, let the dimension be h, right? Let the dimension be h. Now let us say semi-vertical angle is theta. Now look at, this is a, this is b, this is c. Let us say at any instant of time, this is the water position. That means let us say this is the here one cone will be generated. Right. So now I am writing tan theta equals from triangle ADE. This is right angle triangle. This is right angle triangle. Tan theta is nothing but R by H. This is from triangle ADE. This is nothing but from this triangle 5 by 10. From triangle ABC. That means R is nothing but at any instant of time, R will be equal to H by 2. R will be equal to H by 2. That means volume is 1/3 pi R square H. Volume is 1/3 pi R square H. At any instant of time, this is R equal to H by 2. 1 by 3 into H square by 4 into H. 5 is cube. So dv by dt is nothing but 5 by 12 into 3h square into dh by dt. dH by dt, dv by dt is nothing but pi by 4 into h is 4, that means 16. Is nothing but 3 divided by 8 pi. 8 pi meter per minute. This is rate of change of height. Look at next, you see 12, 13, 14. Comprehension, you see 12, 13, 14. 12, 13, 14. 12, 13, 14. Very important comprehension. This is very important comprehension. Look at 12, 13, 14. So look, there is a right circular cone, with initial dimensions given. This is R, this is H. He is telling that contains a liquid. A liquid is already there in the cone. So that liquid evaporates. That liquid evaporates. That means dV by dt. Evaporates at a rate proportional to surface. Surface area in contact with air. In contact with air means what? So that circle is there. In contact with air means that surface area will be the circle. Pi r square. Right? So without circle, the other which is not in contact with air means that is, let us say, pi rl, that surface area. Which is not contact with air means what? Pi RL. Contact with air means this. S equal to pi R square. He is telling that volume evaporates. That water, that liquid evaporates at a rate proportional to S. And proportionality constant is also given, K, which is positive. dV by dt will be negative. That means minus KS. Because it is evaporating and K is positive given. That means it will be equal to minus KS, minus K into pi R square. Let us say this is equation 1. Right? He is telling that dV by dt will be equal to minus K into pi R square. So at any instant of time you take, at any instant of time position will be what after evaporation? Let us say at any instant of time, this much liquid is left out. So this much liquid is left out after evaporation. In that case, take the dimensions small r and small h. So let us say this is b, this is b. At any instant of time, dimensions are small r and small h. Now let us say semi-vertical angle, you take theta. Semi-vertical angle, let us say theta. Now tan theta is nothing but small r divided by small h equal to capital R divided by capital H. Capital R divided by capital H. Now look, H is nothing but R cot theta. Which is nothing but R cot theta. So now look at. So volume is what formula 1 by 3 pi r square h. As it is in r, I am converting this completely into r. That means 1 by 3 pi r square into h is what? R cot theta. R cot theta. That means v is nothing but this state, this semi-vertical angle will not change. That will be constant. That means pi by 3 cot theta into r cube into r cube. That means dv by dt is nothing but pi by 3 cot theta into 3r square dr by dt. 3r square dr by dt. Now dv by dt is given what? Minus k pi r square. Minus k pi r square. So 3, 3 cancel. Pi r square cot theta into dr by dt. Pi r square will get cancelled. Dr by dt is nothing but minus k tan theta. Minus k tan theta. Now look at. So this is minus k into what is tan theta? This is given, this is given. Minus k capital R divided by h. Right? K is given constant. Capital R is fixed. Capital H is fixed. That means this is, let us say, this is a constant, let us say A. Let us say A. That means dr by dt is what? A. A is nothing but this, which is a constant. Dr by dt equal to A means R, if you write R, what you will get? At plus B. Suppose here, look at, this is 2. What you will get? 2t plus B. Look at dr by dt, you do what you will get? Dr by dt is nothing but a into 1 plus 0. That means if dr by dt is a, r is what? At plus b. At plus b. Now, that means r of t. This is r as a function of t is nothing but a is nothing but this. Minus k r divided by h. Plus b. That means r as a, so r is nothing but always it will be like this. So into t plus b. R is a function of time is this. Now look at, if you substitute t equal to 0, at t equal to 0, at t equal to 0, that means initially small r is what? Capital R. Small r is what? At t equal to 0 means complete liquid will be there. Small r will be equal to capital R. That means t equal to 0, you substitute r of 0 equals to 0 plus b. At time t equal to 0, small r is what? Capital R. That means b is what? B is capital R. That means you will get r as a function of time. It is nothing but minus into t plus b means what? Capital R. Capital R. This is the one. So R is a function of time. Now look at the first question. Now look at the first question. 12th. The time at which cone is empty. Cone is empty means r equal to 0. Empty means radius will be what? 0. Radius will be 0. At any instant of time, radius is this. That means this will become 0. Into t plus capital R. Capital R you take common. So that means time is nothing but h divided by k. At this time it will be empty. H divided by k. H divided by k, that b is the answer. That b is the answer. So that is 12th question. Next 13th question, you see. 13th question. The radius of water cone at t equal to 1. Substitute radius at t equal to 1 means r of 1. R of 1 means radius at t equal to 1. T equal to 1 means what you get? Minus kr by h into 1 less r. That means r into 1 minus k by h. Radius at t equal to 1 will be capital R into 1 minus k by h. That a will be the answer. A will be the answer for 13th question. Similarly, for 14th question, sigma, what is asking is, sigma I equal to 1 to, I equal to 1 to 10, R of I equal to dash. R of I equal to dash. So you got R of T value. R of T you got. R. This you got. Into T. Less R. Right. Now substitute the R of I. R of I in place of R of y, I am substituting. I equal to 1 to 10. R of I into I plus capital R. That means write separate sigma. This is constant. There is no I term. Y equal to 1 to 10 I. This is R constant. Y equal to 10, 1 to 10, 1. If there is no I, that is constant, right outside sigma. That means what you will get here, minus kr divided by h, 1, expand sigma, and so on, 10 plus r into 1 plus and so on, 1, 10 times. This into sum of first 10 natural numbers, n into n plus 1 by 2 plus 10r. That means 2 ones, 2 fives. So in these both 5r you take common. 5r if you take common, what you will get? Less 2. That is the answer. So C is the answer. C is the answer. Like that cone related problems. Next, look at next model. Seventh problem, all of you see, seventh. Okay. What he is telling is, a man 2 meters tall walks at the rate of 1/2/3 meters per second towards a street light. Towards a street light, which is 5/1/3 mixed fraction meter above the ground. Look at it. There is a street light. Look at it. There is a street light. There is a street light. So here street light is there. Here street light is there. Street light. So this AB is also called lamp post. In some problems, he will tell that there is lamp post. Right? So this is the street light. So this is the ground level. This is the ground level. Now, man is there. Man is there. Let us say his height is also given. So this is given. So at a height of 5/1/3 meter, that means 16/3 meter. So this is L, this is M, this is man. Right? So man height is 2 meter. So this is 2 meter. Right? Now what he is doing is he is walking. Is walking towards the lamp post, towards the street light, lamp post. That means, let us say from the foot level, from the foot of the lamp post, at any instant he is at a distance of x. At any instant he is at a distance of x. That means he is walking at the rate of dx by dt is given. Dx by dt is given. Dx by dt is given 1/2/3. That means minus 5/3. Minus 5/3 meters per second. Why minus 5/3? Because this distance keeps on decreasing. Keeps on decreasing means rate of change will be what? X is decreasing. That's why negative written. That's my negative reading. What he is asking is how his shadow is changing. Look at in that question, at what rate is the tip of the shadow moving? That is first question. At what rate is the length of the shadow is changing? First we will find second question. At what rate is the length of the shadow changing? So this is man. Let us say shadow is some n here. Some n here. Shadow is ln. Shadow length is ln, let us say. This is y. This is y. Now, join this. So, this is n. Due to this shadow, let us say ln. So, that means what he is asking is dx by dt given. He is asking dy by dt equal dash. Dy by dt equal dash. When he is 3/1/3 meter from the base of the light. That means when he is at some distance. Now look at. For this type of problems, you have to find a relation between y and x. Let us say this is theta. Let us say this is theta. I am writing tan theta from the bigger right angle triangle. What is tan theta? 16/3 divided by x plus y. X plus y. From the smaller triangle, what is that? 2 divided by y. That implies 8y equal to 3x plus 3y. That means 5y equal to 3x. Y equal 3/5 into x. Y equal 3/5 into x. That means dy by dt is nothing but 3/5 into dx by dt. Dx by dt is what? -5/3. 3/5 into -5/3. That means -1 meters per second. माइनस 1 meters per second. So look it. That means dy by dt is nothing but minus 1 meters per second. When he is how much distance, that is immaterial because there is no x and y here. That shadow will change constantly at the rate of decreases at the rate of 1 meters per second. The shadow, if he keeps on moving like this, shadow keeps on decreasing at this rate. So this is second question. Now what he is asking is. Now what he is asking is how the tip of the shadow. Tip of the shadow means what? N. Tip of the shadow is N. How it is moving means that depends on the distance. That means let us say AN. Let us say this is S. Distance is S. AN. AN is nothing but X plus Y. Right? How this distance is changing, his bearing is. So ds by dt, ds by dt is nothing but d by dt of x plus y. That means dx by dt plus dy by dt. Dx by dt is what? Minus 5 by 3 minus 1. That means minus 8 by 3. Meters per second. That means this tip of the shadow is decreasing. It is coming towards it. So this distance keeps on decreasing. It decreases at the rate of 8 by 3 meters per second. Tip of the shadow. This is not there. Look at next problem. Next problem, 11th one, you see, 11th.